Sir, to satisfy you what I have said, stand by among the manner of his teaching.
Mistress, profit you what you read.
What master read you? First resolve me to act.
I read that I profess the art of love.
And made you, sir, master of your art.
Why you speak to you, mistress of my heart?
Quick proceeders, marry! Now tell me, ye that just swear your mistress Bianca, love none in the world so well as who sent you.
Oh, despiteful of unconstant womankind.
Mistake no more. I am not a musician, as I seem to be, but one that scorned to live in this disguise. No, sir, I'm called Hortensio.
Signor Hortensio, I have often heard of your entire affection to Bianca, and since mine eyes are witness of her likeness, I will wed you, if you be so contented, forswear Bianca and her love forever.
See how they woo and pull. Signor Lucentio, here is my hand, and here I firmly vow never to will one of them, but do forswear her for all the former favors I have flattered her withal.
And here I take the unfeigned oath, never to marry with her, though she be indeed. Fie on her, see how beastly she doth court him.
So, that I may surely keep mine oath, I will be married to a wealthy widow ere 3 days pass. It is long loved me, as I have loved this disdainful haggard. And so, farewell, Signor Lucentio.
Mistress Bianca, blessed with such grace, as long as to a lover's blessed case. Nay, I have taken you now, big gentle love, and have forsworn you with Hortensio.
True, you do jest, but have you both forsworn me?
Mistress, we have.
Then we are rid of Lucentio?
I faith, we'll have a lusty widow now, that shall be wooed and wedded in a day.
God give him joy.
Oh, master, I have watched so long that I am dog-weary. But at last I spied an ancient angel coming down the hill. Well, serve the turn.
What is he, Biondello?
Master, schoolmaster, four-headed apparel, and gait and countenance truly like a father.
And what else, Antonio?
If he be credulous, trust my tale. I'll make him glad to see Vincentio, and give assurance to Baptista Manola, as if he were the right Vincentio. Take in your love, and then let me alone.
God save you, sir!
And you, sir, you're welcome. What countryman, I pray?
Of Mantua. Of Mantua? Mary, heaven forbid! And come to Padua, careless of your life?
My life? How, I pray, for that goes hard.
'Tis death for anyone in Mantua to come to Padua. Know you not the cause? Your ships are stayed at Venice, and the Duke of private quarrel twixt your duty hath published and proclaimed it open. 'Tis marvel, but that you are but newly come. You might have heard it elsewhere, like about.
Alas!
Well, sir, to do you courtesy, this will I do, and this I will advise you. First, tell me, have you ever been at Pisa?
Aye, sir, in Pisa have they often been.
Among them know you one Vincentio?
I know him not, but I have heard of a merchant of incomparable wealth.
He is my father, sir, and, sooth to say, in countenance somewhat doth resemble me.
As much as an apple to an oyster, and all one.
Save your life in this extremity. This favor will I do, for his sake. And think it not the worst of your fortune that you are like to serve in Sentio. His name and credit shall you undertake, and in my house you shall be friendly lodged. So shall you stay till you have done your business in the city here. If this be courtesy, sir, accept of it.
Oh, sir, I do. And I will repute you ever, the patron of my life and liberty.
Then go with me to make the matter good. This, by the way, I let you understand. My father is here looked for every day to pass assurance of a dower of marriage twixt me and one Baptista's daughter here. In all these circumstances, I'll instruct you. Go with me to clothe you as becomes.